Today I'm going to demonstrate sclerotherapy using Asclera, which is polidocanol. It's my favorite sclerosant. I did blend the product that's 1% with normal saline to bring it down to 0.5% for these smaller reticular and spider veins. If you use a solution that's too strong, you can get matting. And we see that Leslie does have some matting here from prior injections at another office where the solution was too strong. Let's go ahead and inject. Are you able to see this, Leslie? Let's see if we can get into this vein here. There we go. And you could see it blanching right away. I want you to be able to get a good shot because this is one of my favorite procedures, really. Look at that. Look at those vessels go. Is it uncomfortable, Leslie?
No, not at all.
I love doing sclera because it's immediate gratification.
Wow.
And you can see how effective we are at getting into the vessel with this very fine 32-gauge needle. Now, it looks simple, and as we know in life, things that look simple are not quite so simple. So we want to avoid extravasation into the dermis. Okay, so that's why I bend my needle up a little bit. I inject very superficially, get right into the vein. Sometimes you can often feel like a little pop, but there we go, and we got it. And I inject about 0.1 or 0.2 cc's per injection point. And I don't have a particular pattern that I follow. I just look for a vessel that I'm sure I can get into with my needle. And as you can see, we're very effective at accomplishing that endpoint. Now, typically I have a nurse following me who immediately puts a little compression along these little pinpricks, and it serves a few purposes. It prevents bruising, and it also prevents that superficial thrombus formation. Now, Leslie will go home today with a support hose on. If you're just doing below the knee, she could accomplish that by using a support knee high. And I will instruct her to wear that for 3 days. It does create that she has a better outcome. She does not have to sleep with them. We also ask her to avoid vigorous exercise over the next few days. And we never sclerose veins in pregnant women, because there is a very, very low risk of a blood clot. These are superficial veins. It only, it accounts for 10% of the venous flow in our lower extremities. So it would be very rare to have a deep vein thrombosis from sclerosing materials. However, if you're pregnant, that risk does increase.